Hello everyone, this is Dr. Paul Bora from Assam Downtown University and I welcome you to the video of heat transfer lab. In this particular video, we'll discuss what is emissivity of gray body and how to calculate it. The aim of the experiment is to measure emissivity of the gray body or a gray plate for our particular case at different temperatures. Now, before going to the details, we have to know what is emissivity. So emissivity can be defined as the ratio of emissive power of a surface to that of the black surface. Okay, now what is emissive power? Emissive power is defined as the total amount of thermal energy emitted per unit time, per unit area of a body for all possible wavelengths. Okay. Now this is the apparatus. You can see at the left, there is a rectangular enclosure covered in a glass, and you can see inside the glass there are two plates. One is the black plate, another is the test plate. Both the plates, the specifications are same, and heaters are attached to both the plates so that heat can be supplied, and thermocouples are also attached to both the plates to measure the temperature, and a third thermocouple is also attached to measure the enclosure temperature. This is the specification of the plates, that is the diameter is 0.16 meter and the thickness is 0.009 meter. Theory. Now, radiation is a mode of heat transfer where it does not require any material medium to travel. In this particular mode of heat transfer, the rate at which radiation energy is emitted is usually given by Stefan Boltzmann law, which you can see here. Now in this equation, the epsilon is the emissivity, which is a property of the surface characterizing how effectively the surface radiates compared to a black body, and we have to know that the emissivity of the black body is always considered as 1. Next procedure. Before starting the experiment, we have to ensure all the dimer state. You have seen two dimer state here. One dimer state is that for the heater input of the test plate, and another is the dimer state for heater input of the black plate. Both these dimer states should be rotated to zero position, and the main switch should be off. Then we have to switch on the mains, as you can see here. Then we will rotate this red color knob to supply electricity to the control panel. Then will give heater input to the test plate, you can see here through this dimer state. When the knobs, that is silver knobs, you can see at the left of the control panel, these silver knobs, when these are in the top position, these knobs, where they are in the top position, the voltmeter and ammeter reading will be shown for the test plate, and when it is in bottom position, the voltmeter and ammeter reading, that is see here, the voltmeter and ammeter reading will be shown for the black plate. Okay, now first we have to put it in top, then we'll rotate the knob for the heater input of the test plate, then we'll put it down to give the heater input to the black plate. Now the heater input we should give for the test plate to a range of 70 to 120 volt, and the heater input to the black plate must be little bit higher than that of the test plate. Let us say if the heater input to the test plate is 100 and heater input to the black plate should be 110 volt. Okay. After that, what we have to take the temperature reading of after waiting for some time, we have to take the temperature reading of both the plates, and what you have to do is we have to adjust the temperature of the either black plate or test plate so that the temperature reading of both the plates should be same. Okay, Then after 10 minutes, again we have to wait for 10 minutes, and again we have to take the readings. We'll see that temperature readings are different. Then again we have to adjust the knob, and we have to make sure that both the temperature readings are same. Likewise, we have to perform the experiment. Then these temperature readings can, for different thermocouples, can be shown by the pushing this particular button. You can smell particular switch, you can see here. Okay, after taking all the readings, we have to put down in the observation table, which you can see here. Okay, the voltage input, the current input of the test plate and the black plate, and the temperature, that is T1 and T2, and the T3 is the temperature of the enclosure. Now we'll go to the calculation so that we can find out the emissivity, so that we can know how to find out the emissivity. First, we have to know that enclosure temperature is given by the thermocouple 3, surface temperature is given by the thermocouple T1 and T2, which will maintain as equal. Then we have to add 273 so that we can make the degree Celsius reading to degree Kelvin reading. Heat input to the black plate will be given by V into I, and it is same for the test plate also, which will be given by V into I. Then surface area of the plate we can measure from the specification, and I have also given it here. Now for the black plates, we can say that heat input to the black plate will be equal to the summation of heat losses by convection, heat losses by conduction, and heat losses by radiation. And again, similarly for the test plate also, heat input to the test plate will be given by summation of different heat losses through conduction, convection, and radiation. Now, since the dimension of both the plates are same, we can say that heat loss by conduction and convection for both test plate and black plate will be equal. So if we subtract the earlier two equations, we can say that heat loss or heat input to the black plate minus heat input to the test plate will be equal to heat loss by radiation of the black plate minus the radiation, heat loss by radiation or heat gain by radiation to the test plate. Okay, now you can use the radiation equation here from the Stefan Boltzmann law, and we can find out what is the emissivity of the test plate by using the following equation that you can see here, since we know that emissivity of the black plate is always 1. Now for doing the calculation, we have to know what is the value of A, TS and TE enclosure. We can find out from our observation. Stefan Boltzmann constant is given, and so that we can find out what is the emissivity of the test plate. Thank you.